Alleluia. Christ is risen. Good morning and welcome to worship this seventh Sunday of Easter, our final Sunday in Eastertide. And yes, Easter is a season. Also wishing you today a happy Memorial Day. And amongst the celebrations, I pray that we take time to honor and remember all those who have lost their lives in service. We welcome any visitors or new faces who are joining us today for the first time. We do have a visitor table that is out in the narthex. If you wish to sign our guest register, we would love to get to know you better. A reminder that our circle of friends is being reactivated, and we are attempting to get together some small groups, and the deadline for this particular round is June 1st. So if you are interested in participating in Circle of Friends, please get a hold of Edie Gleam or Patty Bisbing. A reminder that next week, June 5th, is our worship summer schedule change. It may not necessarily affect most of you. We will be continuing our spirit services at 8:30 and 10:30, but our family worship service time is changing from 9:30 to 9:45, and that would be throughout the summer schedule, June, July, and August. And while we're on our family worship, for those of you that might have little ones around or grandkids, we have Family Celebrates. It's a summer pack of faith inspiration cards that are quite fun. We have a lot of extras. If you're interested and want to snag one, they are in the narthex in a basket. We invite you to take some along. Also, next week is Pentecost, so if you want to join in the festive spirit of things, we will be wearing red, and that is the liturgical color, so feel free to wear red next Sunday. Also, a reminder that our blood drive is on June 13th to the 18th. For those that are not aware, there is a significant shortage and need for blood. However, there's also a shortage for staff. So we had originally wanted to do a blood mobile here at the church. They do not have enough staff to accommodate the blood mobile. So we are opening it for an entire week, June 13th to 18th. If you could register, and when you do so, we have a donor ID number that will direct it to Holy Spirit's donation for the blood bank. So if you could do that online, I believe it is in Holy Happenings as well as the website. Amber O'Brien asked that I mention that Catechism Camp registration is open. Our CAT Camp will be held the last week of August this summer. So put the word out for those who need to register to get a hold of Amber. Also, a reminder that Pastor Rick and Deacon Jane's retirement event will be held June 18th outside at 4:30, and then a reception or presentation in the sanctuary later on in that day or that evening. You do need to RSVP to that event so we can prepare better. You can do that online on the registration, on the website, and or the link in Holy Happenings. I think that's it for announcements, but we do have several prayer concerns. Asking you to keep Glenn Schaefer in your prayers. Glenn has surgery later this week, Thursday, June 2nd. We ask for continued prayers for Leona Smith, who remains in Lehigh Valley Hospital. We ask for prayers for Chuck Ballard, who had complications with a kidney procedure, and he is in St. Luke's Allentown. Ina Ashford asks for prayers for her brother Ivan Dotterer, who is also experiencing kidney issues. And finally, Pastor Rick is taking a day off today on vacation, but he asks for prayers for the family and friends of Pastor Susan Lynch. Pastor Lynch was the former associate pastor at New Hanover with Pastor Rick. She was 55 years old and just died from cancer, so we ask that you keep Pastor Susan, family, and friends in your prayers. And we'll end on a prayer of thanksgiving and a time of joy for the wedding of Emily Palmer and Robbie Stevens. That is Deb and Bob Stevens' son, who was married yesterday in Leesburg, Virginia. I think that's it. With that, let us rise and prepare our hearts for worship. We begin with our confession and assurance. Merciful God, raise our sights and our hopes, even as we yearn for the glorious inheritance. We settle for so much less, even as we long to see the extraordinary. We keep our eyes fixed on the ground. Even as we hope to inherit your kingdom, we keep our hearts attuned to earthly power. Even as we desire to rest in the arms of your love, we listen to voices that so may your Holy Spirit find us ready when the Ascended One returns to his own. Amen. Wait patiently for the Spirit to stir your spirit. Wait hopefully to be filled by the living God. For God justifies our hope, and Christ fills our cup with power. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Christ.
Let us pray. O God, form the minds of your faithful people into your one will. Make us love what you command and desire what you promise, that amid all the changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where true joy is found. Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Acts. Once, when we were going to the place of prayer, we were met by a female slave who had a spirit by which she predicted the future. She earned a great deal of money for her owners by fortune-telling. She followed Paul and the rest of us, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God who are telling you the way to be saved." She kept this up for days. Finally, Paul became so annoyed that he turned around and said to the spirit, "In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of her." At that moment, the spirit left her. When her owners realized that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to face the authorities. They brought them before the magistrates and said, "These men are Jews and are throwing our city into an uproar by advocating customs unlawful for us Romans to accept or practice." The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten with rods. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. When he received these orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open, and everyone's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, as he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself, we're all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in his house. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his household were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. He was filled with the joy because he had come to believe in God, he and his whole household. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Second reading from Revelation. "Look, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, and I will give to each person according to what they have done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes, that they might have the right to the tree of life and may go through the gates into the city. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to give you this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David and the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, 'Come,' and let the one who hears say, 'Come.' Let the one who is thirsty come, and let the one who wishes take the free gift of the water of life. He who testifies to these things says, 'Yes, I am coming soon.' Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with God's people. Amen." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
from John, the 17th chapter. Jesus prayed, "My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I want those you have given me to be with me where I am and to see my glory, the glory you have given me, because you loved me before the creation of the world. Righteous Father, though the world does not know you, I know you, and they know you, that you have sent me. I have made you known to them and will continue to make you known in order that the love you have for me may be in them, and that I myself may be in them. This is the good news."
Thanks be to God.
Please pray with me. Gracious and loving God, we are gathered as your children to hear your most holy word. We ask that your Spirit be present with us now, opening our hearts, our minds, our very lives to understanding you more fully, so that we might bear witness to your grace, your mercy, your peace, and your love in our broken world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. We are nearing the end of the Easter season. This past Thursday was Ascension Day, when Jesus went up into the heavenly clouds before the disciples' eyes. And next Sunday is Pentecost, where after his ascension, Jesus pours out the Holy Spirit upon the disciples as promised. Yet here we are today, the seventh Sunday of Easter. And it's an in-between time when the gospel actually takes us back a bit in the timeline to Maundy Thursday. This priestly prayer of Jesus is spoken right after the Last Supper as they were gathered in the upper room, breaking bread, drinking the wine, just moments before they head to the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus will be arrested, tried, and crucified. And Jesus took time right before his death to pray for his disciples, and then to pray for us, for those who will believe in me through their message. If we listen to the prayer, Jesus' sole focus is revealed, that all of them may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me, that they may be one as we are one, I in them, you in me, so they may be brought to complete unity. Jesus knew the disciples were the keys to his future church. And he prays for future believers who will never know his earthly self. That's us. And he prayed that we might experience oneness through the unity of God's love. And this unity of love, friends, is crucial. It is the linchpin, the very hallmark of our Christian witness to the world. Jesus' prayer reminds us that our unity, our oneness, is to be a sign to the world of God's love for all of humanity. Christian unity is a witness to the world. And the corollary holds true as well. Disunity is a witness to the world. At this moment, it might feel that we are engulfed by horrific tragedies, violence that rips apart the fabric of lives and scars soul to the core. Nations, communities, churches, our personal relationships are so often in division and disagreement. Friends, we are easily poised to be overcome by pain and despair. We want Jesus to stop the hurt and to heal us. We want Jesus to answer our prayers. But can we take one moment to stop and consider that the prayer Jesus offered 2,000 years ago has yet to be answered? I wonder if we might pause a moment to look beyond our individual and collective sufferings. If we fix our eyes on a higher horizon, would it help us shift our perspective to see what Jesus wants us to do about it? This last prayer of Jesus is called the Unity Prayer. Unity. That is a pretty poignant plea for our present day, isn't it? The hatred and division that permeates our broken world is about the furthest thing from what Jesus prayed and envisioned for us. Conflict and division among politics, race, denominations, countries, religions, you name it. Division runs rampant in every aspect of our world and our daily lives. Division so deep, they lead to hatred that literally kills one another. Yet Jesus' prayer is ever true. Jesus prayed back then for us now to live in unity of God's love. Does that mean we all get along or agree all the time? No. But it does call us to humbly remember that we are a mere part of a greater whole, a vastly greater whole. We are one in Christ, whether we agree with each other or not. We are one in Christ, whether we like one another or not. To become a part of Christ is to become part of a community that is united in God's love and acts in God's love. Friends, God is working out the master plan for all of creation to live in peace and harmony. And that work is to be done in and through us. There is a force greater than all that divides and separates us from the oneness. And that force, that unifying force of love, is inside our very beings. It's kind of a tough concept to digest. The Holy Spirit in us. But that is exactly what Jesus prays we understand. Jesus prayed that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that the love you have for me may be in them and I myself may be in them. It's that unifying force of love within us that connects all of humanity. And that force is like none other. It is a love that breaks barriers and chains, and yet harmonizes and equalizes. It is a love that stands up for injustice and oppression, and yet a love that finds and binds unity among the diversity, a love that overcomes death, that overcomes the grave, and turns the world upside down. God's love is in us. Does that transform you? Does hearing Jesus' prayer for unity help us see our relationships, our church, our world differently? Does it help us allow the Spirit to move within us and act so we are lifted from that pain and despair and ready to live out the answer to Jesus' prayer? Carolyn Winfrey Gillette is a hymn writer who often writes in response to current contexts and current events. And she very recently wrote these lyrics. And I pray they might inspire hope to lift us up from the pain and the despair and move us to act in God's unifying love. It is titled, If We Just Talk of Thoughts and Prayers. If we just talk of thoughts and prayers and don't live out a faith that dares and don't take on the ways of death, our thoughts and prayers are a fleeting breath. If we just dream of what could be and do not build community and do not seek to change our ways, our dreams of change are false displays. If we just sing of doing good and don't walk through our neighborhood to learn its hopes, to ease its pain, our talk of good is simply vain. God, may our prayers and dreams and songs lead to a faith that takes on wrongs, that works for peace and justice too. Then will our prayers bring joy to you. Friends, the world is aching for us to live into Jesus' most devout moment of prayer. May our lives, may our love finally start to answer Jesus' prayer. For the glory of God, amen. us into the light of a new day, who meets our pessimism with stunning hope of angelic proclamation. I believe in the God of Easter Day, who beats us to the obstacles in our lives and empties the dark tomb for us, who appears in surprising ways when we least expect it, walking with us on our detours. I believe in the God of Easter evening, who breaks into our closets and prisons, bringing peace and crushing our fear. I believe in the risen Lord, who meets us with wounds on his hands and feet, who grants us his spirit, sending us out to bring shalom to the world. Amen.
Set free from captivity to sin and death, we pray to the God of resurrection for the church, people in need, and all of creation. Holy God, make your people one as you and your Son are one. Extend the gifts we have been given by your Spirit to all people, especially those experiencing division or questioning your love. Ascended Lord, make worthy the work of scientists who look to the stars and planets, as well as scientists who look to atoms and molecules, bring innovation and well-being to humanity through their discoveries. Ascended Lord, keep in our minds those who have died in war, both military and civilians, especially the people of the Ukraine. May we honor them by seeking peaceful solution to the conflicts that arise among nations and peoples. Ascended Lord, grant freedom to all who are overwhelmed by chronic illness, depression, or constant worry. Bobby, Stephanie, Louise, Leah, Corbin and family, Darlene, Jace, Robbie, Paul, Pam, Pat, Helen, Elaine, Claire, Kevin, Linda, Leah, Stacy, Tom, Donald, Greg, Deacon Jane, Scott, Eric, Stephanie, Becky, Adam, Glenn, Jane, Denny, Millie, Lisa, Deborah, Lisa, Marilyn, Joanne, Patricia, Reinhold, Aaron, Fred, Rosie, Christopher, Debbie, Janie, John, Donna, Jim, Lester, Karen, Lisa, Douglas, Rachel, Nancy, Sue, Grayson, Asley, Jess, Matthew, Katie, Helen, Nick, Tanya, Ray, Ann, Ross, Alice, Robert, Denise, Tom, Ksenia, Renee, Phil, Andrew, Jean, Peggy, Glenn, Sherry, Leona, Patricia, Wilma, Al, Tammy, Timothy, Grace, Tony, Tori, Melanie, Mike, Don, Stephanie, Allie, Doris, Judith, and Betty May. Open them to receive health and salvation in Christ Jesus through the Spirit's gift of faith. Ascended Lord, stir imagination and understanding through the church in the work of poets, theologians, and hymn writers. Lead us into new visions and fresh expressions of your presence. Ascended Lord, God of resurrection, we remember before you those who have died, children, teachers, and staff of Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas. We commend them to your eternal love. Grant healing and wholeness to the survivors who are wounded or traumatized, and restore all whose spirits are maimed by such violence, that we may serve as your arms of care to those in distress. Ascended Lord, unite us with the saints who have died and been raised in Jesus' name, especially Pastor Susan Lynch. Train us to wait with eager longing for Christ to come again even as we sense his presence with us now, ascended Lord.
We trust you to hear our prayers.
Ascended Lord, we trust that you will hear our prayers and answer with what we need. We pray this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God of us all. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. Please share a sign of peace with one another. Peace be with you. We take a moment to say thank you for all that you give, all that you share, and all that you offer our church so we can continue in the mission of sharing God's love and peace with the world. We have offering plates located at the back of the sanctuary by the doors. Also reminding you there is a variety of online giving options for you to give in a way that is most convenient for you. We thank you and our musical offering.
But they don't.
Please rise. At this time, I also remind our folks who are worshiping on Zoom to go ahead and prepare for sharing in communion, getting your bread, your wine, or your grape juice ready. May the God of wonder be with you. Lift your hearts to the one who invites you to this table, calling, come, come. Thirsty for life and hope, we bring our hearts to this feast. Rejoice in the Lord, all you people. We sing glad songs of thanks to God's holy name. With those who thirst for righteousness and with those who hunger for justice, we lift our voices to you.
My fault.
Do over. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me. As we celebrate his life and love, as we testify to his peace and hope, we witness to that mystery called faith. Christ died that we may enter the holy city by the gates. Christ was raised that we may receive the water of life as a gift. Christ will come soon, your grace calling us home. Come, holy God, come, pouring out your spirit upon this feast, transforming your children with the simple gifts of the bread and cup. As we eat of the bread, we find you within us, uniting us wherever we are divided, healing us where we are broken, sending us when we are reluctant, to throw open wide all that imprisons our sisters and brothers throughout the world. As we drink from the cup, we realize how deeply we know you, and will go forth to witness to all around us, that the love with which you have loved us may be in them, and we in them. And when the end of all time has come, when the Alpha and Omega invites us to come, we will gather around your table in the holy city, clothed in your grace with all the saints. We will sing your praises forever and ever. God in community, holy in one. Amen. Let us join in praying the prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The risen Christ dwells with us here. All who are hungry, all who are thirsty, come. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. You are a loved child of God.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, generous God, for in this bread and cup we have tasted the new heaven and earth, where hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from this table as witnesses to the resurrection, that through our lives all may know life in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Lift up your eyes to the heavens.
Christ ascended to show us the way.
Trust the Spirit's power.
Christ ascended to clothe us with power.
Go as witnesses of the risen Lord.
Christ ascended to bring us eternal life.
May God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and always.